Yeah. Be a little disappointed that there were no more, you know, defections for the independent group?
Well, it's early days. I mean, we have a lot of MPs who are sick and tired of the failure of British politics and the old political parties. Eight of us from the Labour Party decided our patience ran out and we decided to become independent. Three members of the Conservative Party simultaneously. We'll see what happens with this Brexit issue. To be honest, there's a lot of Labour MPs, Conservative MPs, absolutely sick and tired at the front benches, the leaderships of the two parties, just sort of looking at their internal party advantage. Mm-hmm. And it's going to be interesting to see how that goes.
Okay, are they sick and tired of the Prime Minister? Is it now time that she goes? And can they topple her now?
The problem is, of course, and it's happening all over the world, that you're seeing populism shifting the, what were parties that were more in the centre ground to the ideological fringes.
Right.
And if Prime Minister Theresa May goes, you're probably going to get a more right-wing Conservative MP. Moderate Conservatives will not like that. And so that will create a fraction in the Conservative Party. Similarly, in the Labour Party, move to the hard left, actually supporting Brexit, mm-hmm. enabling Brexit, a lot of Labour MPs actually want to have a referendum, another chance for the public to have a final say. If they're not doing that, that may also split the Labour Party further.
OK, it seems we have the same number of options as we did a couple of months ago. Even if MPs vote against a no-deal Brexit now and an extension, it could still happen mid-May or mid-June. What do you think that the most likely scenario is?
I personally think that MPs now are going to take control over the situation. Your American viewers will know and be more used to a legislature being able to assert itself over an executive. We're not used to that so much in the UK, but actually, if MPs across a party basis say, we want to steadily and methodically go through all the Brexit options and perhaps put those Brexit, that favoured option, on a ballot paper in a public vote, I still think that is an option. Because if there's an impasse, where else do you go?
But given what we've seen in the votes, what would Parliament actually agree on? What kind of Brexit deal would Parliament vote on favourably?
Well, one idea is that the Prime Minister should have the option to put her deal to the public, but against the concept of staying in the EU, so that there's a choice to be had. It might be that there's
isn't this a headache?
Well, of course, nobody particularly wanted to get into this particular situation. But when the elected representatives can't agree, where else do you go but to say to the public, we've tried our best, there's no resolution, are you sure you want to proceed, or do you want to call the whole thing off?
Right, but given what you've just said, it means that a no-deal Brexit is still on the table, and probably the chances of that are still increasing.
I don't think so. I think MPs today will be very clear, we're not going to crash out with no deal. I absolutely believe that's the case. And the Prime Minister tomorrow will probably be instructed, or she may of her own volition, say we want to extend past the 29th of March. So I'm quite confident that will happen. The question is, do we extend for a short period or to the autumn? That's all to play for.